perfect boards for shelving in here, but this will be a good start. And maybe once lumber prices come down, I'll buy something that fits perfectly in here. Right now, I'm down in the basement in what we refer to as the root cellar. Although we don't actually store any roots in here, it's just kind of a storeroom off one end of the basement. And during the pandemic, we started buying food in bulk. So we have all sorts of boxes of stuff, and we've run out of shelf space. So I put some shelves over here above the chest freezer. These other shelves over here are full. We got some boxes with some stuff sitting on the floor. And while we don't really need all this stuff around all the time, when you order online, you end up with case lots. And sometimes you just need a little bit here and there, and some of these case lots are going to last us for a year or two. So it makes sense to me to get them put up off the floor, and hopefully we'll be able to see what we have a little bit better. Now, one problem with ordering a bunch of stuff online is we tend to accumulate a lot of boxes. So I need to break down some boxes, because this weekend is recycling weekend, so today or tomorrow morning I can take stuff to be recycled. Now, a lot of these boxes do get saved to ship things back out, but we can't use all of them, so recycling is the way to go. Well, it's starting to look a whole lot better in here. Getting those boxes all bundled up makes a big difference. You know, you ever look in the mirror and realize you really need a haircut? Sometimes Janet says I start to look like Dilbert's boss. Okay, that ought to be a little bit better. Where was I? Like I said, this is what we call the root cellar, but mostly it's dry goods and canned goods, things like that. We've got a shelf that holds various kitchen gadgets, cast iron skillets, things like that that we don't use very much. They just live down here. And of course, boxes pile up down here. And when we're down here, the cats like to find out what we're up to. This is George. He thinks he's special. Years ago, before we even built this house, we went to an auction in Trinidad, Colorado, and we bought this cool old freezer door. And we weren't sure what we were going to do with it, but when we built this house and we knew there was going to be this basement space here, we decided this was the place to put it. So it does keep it a little bit cooler in here because of this big, heavy, insulated old wooden door. We certainly don't do all of our shopping online anymore, but we're still going to do quite a bit of it that way, and I'll share with you just a little bit about some of the places we go. Now, if you're outside the U.S., probably none of these are available to you, and some of them probably aren't even available if you're outside of our area. Now, we certainly are not doing as much grocery shopping online as we were, but we did find it to be pretty darn convenient. There's a lot of these places we're going to keep shopping from for quite some time now, not because we're worried about COVID, but because it is quite convenient. For us, it's about an hour and a half, 2 hour round trip to go in, go grocery shopping. Beulah and Pueblo can have kind of limited taste, so there's a lot of things that we like to have that simply aren't available, so shopping online really does work out for us. So I got a little list here that I will give you some of the names of the places we've used. This is hardly a complete list, but these are some of the ones that we're probably going to keep going back to for quite some time. Of course, the biggest one is Food Service Direct. They supply restaurant quantities and restaurant-type foods. They ship anything from canned food, dried food, frozen food, and we have bought a lot of stuff from them, everything from frozen raviolis to potato chips, pickles, soy sauce, pasta sauce, all that kind of stuff. Now, like most of these places, shipping can be a little bit expensive, but with Food Service Direct, if you buy enough, you can get free shipping, and they frequently send you out an online coupon, so you can get free shipping on smaller quantities, so that's handy. Another place we bought small quantities of groceries, things like dried nuts and dry fruit, things like that, is a place called iHerb, perhaps I should say. And I will try to put links to all this stuff. I'm going to see if I can find the websites, and I'll put all these down in the video description so you can find them if you're interested in these places. And no, I'm not sponsored by any of these places. They haven't sent me any free stuff. None of them have any idea I'm talking about them. These are just places that we found that we like to shop. Of course, the bagels from New York Bagels are some of the best bagels I've ever had, and I will never go back to buying grocery store bagels. For fresh vegetables and fruit, we used a place called Farm to Fork, Colorado, and that's just a local thing. They wouldn't deliver to us out here in Beulah, but they would deliver to Pueblo. So about once every week or 2 weeks, we would have a box delivered to a friend's house in Pueblo. And for that, we did drive in, but we didn't have to go put up with a grocery store. And in most cases, it was better produce than you got at the grocery store. For meat, we used several different places. Sangre's Best is a place over near Westcliff, Colorado. Bay's Meat Market, which is in Pueblo. Now, Bay's, again, we had to go in and pick it up, but they would bring it out to your car. And for a while, they were only doing 50-pound boxes, so you had to get their 50-pound stock your freezer box, and whatever was in it is what you got, but it was worth buying to have stuff to stock the freezer with. And then Rafter W Ranch, and I don't know if they're in Colorado or if they might even be in Wyoming. I'll check the website link if you're interested. But all of those places, and also a place called Tender Belly, which we bought bacon and sausage, things like that from, have all really been good sources for meat. Once it ships, ship it frozen, it comes on dry ice, and we never really had a problem with anything thawing out. There was a few times some frozen food from Food Service Direct arrived kind of on the verge of thawing out, but it really hasn't been much of a problem. Spices come from Savory Spice Shop. We've been using them for years, so it was nothing new to buy spices from Savory Spice Shop. And Spice Jungle was another place we bought spices. And they're much better spices than you get at the grocery store. So again, that's someplace you simply get higher quality stuff if you don't mind paying a little bit extra to buy it online and have it shipped. For flour, King Arthur Flour and Central Milling Company. They have both been good sources for flour and other things you need for baking. Keith Gusto Bread Club. That's something we just found. It's San Francisco sourdough, and we get 4 loaves every 2 or 3 weeks, something like that. And it is wonderful bread. It's well worth doing, but it is a little bit on the pricey side. Of course, anytime you want San Francisco sourdough and you're not in San Francisco, that's just the way it is. Murray's Cheese for cheese. I think that's another place we just found recently. And at the beginning of the pandemic, everybody was panicking over toilet paper. But again, for a couple of years, we've been using a place called Who Gives a Crap? And they send recycled toilet paper out by the case. And we already had a big stock of toilet paper, so when that crunch hit, we didn't have to worry about it. I realize it's a bit of a strange video to just talk about where we go grocery shopping, but shopping online has been really convenient, and even though the pandemic kind of put us into that situation, I think we're going to keep doing it now that the pandemic has pretty much run its course. It's not a problem for us anymore. We can safely go to the grocery store. But if I have my choice, I'd rather just stay home and have it delivered. Anyways, I hope you found that interesting. Give it a thumbs up if you did, and we will see you for the next video.